An association between three entities is called a ternary association. A typical example is an association between an employee, the project they are working on, and their role in that project. If the role is a complex object, you might decide to model this as three entity classes. The association between them is the interesting part. You have two main options to model it on your entity classes. You either map the association table as an entity class or as a java.util.Map. Hi, I'm Tom Janssen. If you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Let's first take a quick look at the table model. Each of the three entities and the association between them gets stored in its own database table. I called the association table Project Assignment. It follows the same concept as the association table of a many-to-many association. It contains the three foreign keys of the associated entities and uses all three of them as its derived primary key. Let's go to the IDE and have a look at it. The easiest approach is to map the association table as an entity. I map it to the project assignment class. Three of its attributes are the many-to-one associations to the employee, project, and role entities. The fourth one, the ID attribute, is of type project assignment ID. This is an embeddable that models the three attributes of the primary key. The map's ID annotations on the association attributes tell Hibernate to use the primary key value of the associated entities as a part of the primary key value of this entity. The value of each map's ID annotation references an attribute of the project assignment ID embeddable. This is the attribute to which Hibernate will map the primary key value of the associated entity. That is a typical mapping of a derived primary key. I explain it in great detail in my Advanced Hibernate online training. These are all required parts of the mapping. To make the associations easier to use, I recommend to model them bidirectionally. As I explain in my guide to association mappings, you can easily do that by adding an attribute of type setOfProjectAssignment to each of them. You also need to annotate it with a one-to-many annotation. Its mapBy attribute references the name of the attribute on the project assignment entity that represents this association. Hibernate can also map this association as a java.util.Map. As I showed in a previous article, that mapping is very flexible. In this example, I want to model the association on the person entity. The project entity becomes the map key and the role entity the value. The implementation of such a mapping is straightforward. You need an attribute of type map of project and role, and a few annotations. The one-to-many annotation defines the association, the join table annotation specifies the name of the database table that represents this association. The map key join column annotation tells Hibernate which column in the join table it shall use as the key of the map. That's all you need to do. You can now use the map in your business code to add new project assignments or get the role of a person in a project. You can map a ternary association in multiple ways. The two most common ones map the association table to an entity class or a java.util.Map. In most projects, I prefer to create an entity class that represents the association table. That mapping is closer to the table model, easier to understand, and more flexible. But in some projects, your business logic always accesses the associated elements via their key. In these situations, Hibernate's support to represent your association as a java.util.Map makes your job much easier. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!